Okay, well, here's a little video to show what I've been doing with the car paint-wise. The last few weeks I've been trying to make the car look a little nicer. Paint job was completely dull and shot, so I decided to, and this is after restoring the headlights to almost new condition. As you can see, I found a way online to sand and polish the 14-year-old headlights and make them look brand new again, so I can get better headlight action at night, so I can see better when I'm driving at night. Anyway, I also took a lot of time to study how to paint your own car with spray cans, $3.89 spray cans. And so that's what I've been doing. This is the result of a couple of weeks of study and then working on it and sanding and messing around with it. That's the front of the car. It used to be really dull. But anyway, this is Rust-Oleum Clear Coat Gloss finish, and I'm certainly no expert. As you can see, it's got some flaws in it. Well, it's not flaws that you're looking at now. These are just dusty, dirty marks that come right off. However, there are some flaws. I'll show you what I'm talking about. It's mostly runs. That is a run there. See that? See the shadow on that? It's where the paint got a little bit too thick. And it started to run. But you know, I'm so impressed at the shine that I don't care that much. There's another run right there. There's a couple runs there. But again, you could actually see the metallic characteristics of the car. There's a little orange peel finish there too, but it's at least it's glossy now instead of dull and oxidized. See there? Yeah, that's kind of a nice look compared to what it was. It looks like a kind of a shiny new paint job. And the roof was in the worst shape. It's good and shiny now. It still has to be buffed out and polished with the polisher and little elbow grease. The back is too dark to see, really. But it's pretty shiny too. It was completely dull. And then again, there's your top of the car. And down here to the side and the front again. That's looking pretty good right there. That front. And that's about three coats of clear gloss Rust-Oleum. So it's been about $50 worth of spray cans so far. And I'm pretty much, I have some to do on the sides, but I'm not as concerned about the sides as I was about the top part. You can see down here, well, it's kind of dark. I'm going to show you what it used to look like. Let's see over here, maybe we can see better here. Yeah, that's kind of like it used to look like right there compared to this. Quite a difference, huh? Again, a dull, oxidized look. And keep in mind, this car has only had two owners, and at this time in 2015, the car was manufactured in 2001. It still only has 80,000 original miles on the engine and the car and everything else. So that's an incredibly low amount of mileage for the age of the vehicle. So it's worth keeping and driving. It's paid for and it's pretty economical to transportation at this point. So that's what I'm doing. Of course, it does have the darkened windows, the 5% light windows, so that keeps the sun out in the daytime, except for the windshield. It's a little dicey at night. You sometimes have to roll down the windows to see where you're going when you're turning a corner in order to see out at night because of the 5% room darkening. Window tint, which I installed myself too. That's quite a tricky thing to do. Certainly not a perfect job, but it will do for now. I also did this side over here, this passenger door window. Notice you can't really see in the car. You see a reflection of the shelves around, but you don't see in the car. So that's nice.